Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to the best day of the week. Tourney Tuesday is back. We had Gap Week last week. I hope each and every one of you had an awesome 4th of July. I was up at Steph's grandparents' cabin doing a lot of bassing, hanging out with family, just really enjoying time with family and friends, and some fishing too. It was awesome. But either way, tonight is the best night of the week. Tonight is Tourney Tuesday. And tonight, even though it was an outstanding showing by Steph the Great last week, tonight, we've got the old, the one, the only, the infamous B-Rock! Fourth of July was good. Had a great time out with friends and family. I actually guess didn't really see my family, but great time with some friends. Drank plenty of drinks. Saw some fireworks. Other than that, just pretty laid back. Not too bad, but fishing's been good. Fishing's been really good. Yeah. Always is.
Last time B-Rock gathered us for Tourney Tuesday, it was week one.
Week number one, first one. And now it's week number five. And a lot of good things have happened in between. And we're hoping to repeat tonight. Last year, Steph and I fished this lake in Tourney Tuesday, and we got third place with 18 pounds. We cracked them. And believe it or not, we actually caught them on drop shot. And like I said, this lake is the jungle. There is milfoil, there's coontail, there's reeds, a bunch of little islands, there's a bunch of wood in the water. It's a greasy bass factory. At times this lake can be very stingy and tough to get a bite, but then other times the big ones, they come out to play. And fingers crossed, that's what happens tonight. So we'll probably be doing a lot of junk fishing, just kind of feeling it out, maybe flipping some weeds, maybe doing some frogging, maybe doing a little bit of drop shotting. I don't know. We're just gonna kind of see what the bass tell us and go from there. But yeah, tonight's awesome. The conditions tonight, it is like 80 degrees with a 15 mile an hour wind, and it's beautiful. It is absolutely beautiful. Oh, and by the way, we've got some new hats coming soon. Not yet, just coming soon. Either way, it's good to be back at Tourney Tuesday. We're gonna get things wrapped up here. We're pretty much rigged. We're just gonna strap some things down, and we have a later boat draw tonight. But yeah, probably won't matter. We'll be fishing behind people all night. So Tourney Tuesday begins in 3, 2, 1.
Big ball going forward.
Flying from the back.
Get it out! Woo!
Just a quick recap of Tourney Tuesday, what it is, and the season so far. Tourney Tuesday is a local grassroots tournament fishing trail that happens on Tuesday nights. We go for 5 bass, total weight takes it all, and each week we compete on different lakes kind of around the metro, south metro, and we keep track of points every week. So if you get first place, you get 1 point. If you get second place, you get 2 points. Third place, 3 points, so on and so forth. And the team with the least amount of points at the end of the year is team of the year. So week number one, we got the dub. Week number two, we got the dub. Week number three, we got second. And week four last week, we got the dub, and Steph the Great cracked it all the way out of the park. So tonight, we're just hoping to get 5. Hopefully they're bigger than everybody else.
We're good.
And yeah, let's get on to spot number one.
Spot one, boys.
Spot one, let's get it off. Give me some of that.
Woo!
Let's get it off.
Let's get it off.
Oh, I'm feeling it.
I can feel something inside me saying we're gonna catch up, I'm kind of know. Do you believe in big girls? I believe.
All right, spot number one. We're gonna start out
flipping. We're gonna flip some milfoil. Every lake's different, but certain lakes, especially in the middle of July, they can just pile in beautiful green milfoil. There's bluegills, bait, everything underneath the sun. It's great cover. So we're just gonna chuck a big ol' 5/8 ounce tungsten with a craw tube. Rock's using a jig. Down in that foil, shake it around. See what we can do.
One, boys, that's one.
You need a new line, or you got too light a line for flipping? Do you have 30 or 50 or 65? That's a giant bass. You re-spool to 65 or something heavy. Or just re-spool that line.
Too light line.
Shoot. It was a giant. There we go.
Could be a pike.
God, he was running more. There could be more. No, no. I saw the one you dumped. I bet I got on GoPro. All right, number two. The one that jumped for you was big, but we'll get him back. Are we raptor down? Nice. Number two.
Oh, you're running.
Dude, yeah,
that was unbelievable.
Nice job.
Number three.
Number three!
Number three.
All right, 5:27. We've only been fishing 27 minutes. We've had four bites, off to a good start. We got three in the well. All flipping. This was kind of a, I don't know. All fishing is decisions, not guesses, but educated guesses. And this was, going flipping foil was kind of an educated guess. two more bites. Right here. Brock! It's all good.
Chaos, man. That's the chaos. Gotta love it.
Alright, number four. Alright, we just boated number four. After those first three bites right away in the derb, we haven't got anything for probably 20-25 minutes. We're going really slow. We're moving 5 feet, raptoring down. Flip, make the milfoil swish cheese. Going 5 more feet, raptoring down. Flip. Slow and steady. Very slow and steady. It seems like you gotta hit him right in the dome to get him to bite. It's four. Current time check is 6:41. We have 2 more hours to fish. We have 5 fish in the box. They're all decent, no big ones yet. We're gonna bounce around to a couple of our spots and then head back to where we started. Alrighty, spot number three. It's 7:01
and just same song and dance, frogging, flipping, a little bit of jigs, a little bit of T-rig. We don't have much weight. We need some big bass. All right, that spot was no good. We're gonna make a run to the totally other side of the lake. All right, current time check, 7:28. The tournaments are a little earlier now. They're 8:45 just because the sun goes down sooner. So we've got about an hour and 15 minutes, probably an hour and 5 minutes to fish. We're gonna run to the totally other side of the lake and fish this back little swamp, just like a creek mouth, full of cheese, full of pads, full of milfoil, and I think we're gonna frog, hopefully, our way to greatness. So, all right, let's get it. Need one, big one. We need some big ones.
Or if those are wheat, I don't know. I never felt like I found that wheat patch.
Yeah. A lot of twitches.
No, no, you're good.
That's way too small, huh?
Got him.
Yo, go. That a big. That a big. That one cold. That one cold.
Are you moving it fast?
Decently, yeah. I mean, a lot of twitches. Not moving it far, but a lot of twitches.
There's another cold game frogging. Love that.
All right, we got like 20 minutes. We're gonna hit one more spot. We gotta make something happen. Brock with a major cull there. Not a giant, but ounces are ounces. One more spot.
I don't know, man. We just need to catch one. One big one.
Give me a hope, Spears and Dreams.
Hopes, we catch one that we need, like a 5-pounder. Fears, I break my line again. And dreams, we catch 5 big ones.
Let's go.
Let's do it.
B-Rock again on the jig.
Oh, man. That was crazy. He done followed you up.
Yeah, and I'll try. Nothing? No, I think we're just rotating, huh?
Yeah. There we go.
Whew. Wow, how about them apples?
All right, time is up. We gotta head back. We did what we could. Broke off one fish. It's just the way it goes. That fish that I broke off was like probably a 4-pounder. Really would have helped, but what do, you know? It's fishing.
That's fishing.
Let's go. We got 5.
$8.44. We're in with 1 minute to spare. We were beached at 8:41. Brock hops out of the boat, pushes us super hard. We get out, we fire back here. Wow, we gave it our all tonight. We fought really hard. We didn't have very many big bites. We didn't have that many bites in general. I think we called 2 or 3 times. Yeah. So, I mean, maybe we only caught 8 or 9 bass. It seemed like they weren't committing to the frog. The flipping bite right away was good, and I was like, dang, it kind of feels like they're eating around. Thank goodness we got on them hot and heavy right away and got 5. Main deals, we got 5. We upgraded, and we fished hard. We fished hard. Let's go weigh these bad boys in.
Well, we made it to weigh-ins. Rumor on the street is there was a 6-8 caught. Their motor didn't even work. They just trolling motored out there and caught them. Like, I think they ended up with like 19 pounds. So
they're probably gonna win.
Yeah, kudos to them. Like, they went out and they smashed them. But I guess let's get these in the bag and see how much they weigh.
Yeah,
there's number one. They're a gorgeous one.
Here's our pals, Matt and Alexia. With the lucky banana shirt.
Skinny one. It's all like cookie cutter fish.
Yeah, all cookie cutter, like 2.5 pounders. Bingo, baby, 5 alive. What do you think?
12 some, 12 and a half.
I'm calling 13.
13? Not a bad guess. I mean, 2 times 5 is...
Yeah.
And
let's go see. Let's go see.
We ran our plan tonight and it worked. We caught bass doing it. We didn't get any of those big bites. And that's part of fishing. I'm proud of us. We've been fishing this lake since we were young, but we've never really fished it like this. We learned a lot about this lake tonight. And even just talking to people during weigh-ins, we learned a lot about this lake. Lakes change so much year to year. I don't care if you've had good days on a lake last year or 2 years ago, or you used to crush them out here when you were a kid. It doesn't matter. These lakes change so much. So
we ended up weighing 13 pounds, 13, 14. I don't know if it's ounces or what it is, but
I 13.14. I think it might be. Yeah. So maybe I don't know.
Under 13 and a quarter.
Yeah.
13 and a quarter would be 13.25.
Yeah.
I think. just under 13 and a quarter pounds. Lost a big one that hurt right away, but that's fishing like we've been saying. But we toughed it out, we grinded it out, we fished our best, we did what we could, and fished a new way, and it was fun doing that, for sure.
And 13.14 was good enough for...
Sixth place?
Sixth place tonight.
So, not terrible points, it's not 15 points, it's only 6, so hopefully that'll be our throwaway for the year, because you get one throwaway a year. We just gotta come back next week and do better.
And the team that won it tonight, huge shout out to them.
Man, huge.
They had motor troubles right away at the beginning of the Derby. And obviously, they just were going to fish a tournament out of their trolling motor.
Yeah.
They trolled over to some reeds, and they basically stayed there all night long.
All night long. They just worked in a circle.
And they caught 19 pounds to win it.
Almost 20. 1982, I think it was, with a 6.28.
Yeah. Such a rare fish in Minnesota.
Super rare fish in Minnesota. Absolutely. Yeah. Props to them. Good for them.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video all the way to the end. Make sure you go subscribe to B-Rock. He makes hunting, fishing, foraging, camping videos all summer, all winter long. Please, I'll link his channel right in the description of this video. Go check it out. Subscribe to him. And thank you guys for watching. I'll list all the baits, rods, everything we use down below. And next week could be interesting too. Tourney Tuesday's back and the season just got real. Thank you so much for watching the video all the way to the end. I guess there's nothing to be said, and stay tuned. And as always, let the adventure begin.